Hitman 3 is easily one of the most interesting and impressive games of the last several years, culminating a trilogy of titles each developed under completely different circumstances. But it's also very clearly the third game in this trilogy, designed mainly for those that have already adored the first two, which I know sounds obvious, but you'd be surprised. Is Hitman 3 a great game for you to pick up, even if you're new to this trilogy? Let's just cut right to it. Yes, it absolutely is, if you're patient. First things first, developer IO Interactive provided me with a PlayStation 5 copy of Hitman 3 for this review, and only of Hitman 3. I already owned a copy of Hitman 1 thanks to PlayStation Plus, and I liked that game so much when I reviewed it a few years back that I bought Hitman 2 immediately. Those prequels are important here not just because obviously Hitman 3's story is the capstone of the trilogy's half-decade of story build, but also because Hitman 3, like 2 before it, allows you to carry forward all of the levels from the previous games, even from previous consoles, and even your Hitman 2 save progress. This means that you can obtain almost 20 full sandbox levels, each with usually dozens upon dozens of unique completion criteria, bonus missions, their own experience progression, everything, all at no cost if you own all three games, or for a usually cheap price if you haven't bought the first two yet. Just to limit any possible spoilers for Hitman 3 as much as I can, I'm gonna be cycling footage from all three of these games within Hitman 3's updated engine, so if something looks familiar to you Hitman fans, it might be. This overwhelming amount of content might sound intimidating, because it is. Notwithstanding the trilogy's story so far, which you can recap in 3 before starting, and let's be honest, it doesn't really matter that much anyway, this is not Shakespeare, Hitman 3 starts as if you already know what you're doing. Outside of the standard tutorial, Hitman 3 is a game that expects you to be at least versed in Agent 47's capabilities before you begin, to the point that when I entered the first level, this tall, intimidating super skyscraper in Dubai, I struggled a bit to find a good path forward, and I'm somebody at least decently experienced in the previous two games. In Hitman's so-called World of Assassination trilogy, Agent 47 is sent into a sandbox-style location, places like a French fashion show, a sprawling Chinese city covered in cameras, even a pleasant Vermont suburb secretly inhabited by a former Soviet spy. Agent 47 is tasked with eliminating one or more targets, sometimes stealing some intel, and escaping without making too much noise. Or, you know, making as much noise as you want. These sandboxes vary quite a bit in scale, but almost all of them allow you the freedom to infiltrate and assassinate just about however you'd like. You can poison somebody discreetly while dressed up as a waiter, you can dress up as a guard to get high-level access to your target, you can just thwump a screwdriver into somebody's eye or throw soda cans or save scum and aim to do the most ridiculous assassinations possible if you want to be stupid. I usually like being stupid in these games, so you're going to see a lot of that today. And that's the thing here, every player is going to have a totally different path through Hitman 3's levels based on how they think and approach the game's problems, how they explore. And so while I might not have liked Dubai at first, you might love it. And for a lot of you in this case, your enjoyment may depend on how patient you are. These games sometimes ask you to put a lot of setup into your assassinations, either waiting to get a target isolated so you don't have to alert guards, or waiting to get a guard isolated so you can even get into a locked area without being seen as a trespasser. Your first time through every level is probably gonna take about an hour at minimum, and in some cases, you'll find yourself unsure of how to actually access specific areas. If you're not really the type to take the time to plot and explore, these Hitman games may not grab you before you get bored. And in Hitman 3's case, that's doubly true, because I would argue this game has a much slower introduction thanks to the first levels being far more catered to the bigger Hit fans out there. The second level, a British manor home to a murder mystery subplot with secret bookcase switches to open hidden pathways, is arguably more fun after you've beaten the level once or twice and know where the rooms you're supposed to be investigating actually are. But if you can make it to the third level and beyond, you'll experience what I would say are three of the trilogy's strongest levels back to back to back, with an excellent final level to cap the saga off to boot. I just loved exploring this exclusive German nightclub, playing a deadly game of cat and mouse with assassins that are hunting Agent 47 just as he's hunting them. It's a great subversion of the trilogy's formula, one of a few times that Hitman 3 really plays with the expectations that fans might have going in. The rainy, neon-lit Chongqing is so massive that it may as well be two full levels, and it's a contender for being my favorite level in the entire series. Hitman 3 is a slow burn game, even compared to the previous two entries, but its payoff is stellar. The thing about Hitman, though, is that once you've played a level once or twice, and by playing more stealthily, you'll earn experience towards mastering that level and unlock new gear such as weapons or a permanent lockpick, new outfits to start with or locations to start from, and other tricks that make replaying each location more fun as you polish your kill skills. So while I may have been critical of Dubai on my very first playthrough, I quickly grew to love it as my equipment options expanded a bit, and once I really started sharing stories and ideas with a few of my buddies. Despite being entirely single player at this point, Hitman is still a social experience, because each run is its own stupid tale that you get to tell somebody or share with the world. Like the time I dumped an assassin's corpse into a bin at the very same second a security guard walked into the room trying to hunt me down, only to see me disguised as the same guard pretending to hunt myself. Or the time I used a single katana in Hitman 1's hotel level, just tossing it like a lawn dart at hundreds of guards again and again and again until the game itself feared my power. Seeing the way all of the game's different systems and AI patterns come together when you execute a plan perfectly, or very imperfectly really, is what makes it all worth it. And once you feel especially comfortable with this game, or any of the games really, you can tackle each level's master difficulty, which cuts back on the in-level hints and limits you to one save per attempt. If you're just playing through the story, it might only take you 6 to 7 hours to be done with it, but you can easily manage 40 or more hours out of each Hitman game with all of the secondary objectives and challenges, and Hitman 3, like 1 and 2 before it, is home to a number of escalation missions where you're tasked with some clue-like modifiers like hit this woman with a shovel, then knock out an assassin before you kill him, and then shove this guard into a closet. Now, of course, since Hitman 3 is so new, it doesn't have nearly as many of these secondary challenges as I'd already had by getting 1 and 2's DLC passes on sale over the years, but that's to be expected. Even still, you can find more than your fair share of bonus content by going into the game's online modes, including Contracts mode, where you can create and play custom player-created objectives, the timed elusive target challenge missions, and much more. And that brings me to the other sticking point you may run into before purchasing. Hitman 3 is currently an online required game, despite not having online multiplayer whatsoever. You can play offline, but doing so loses you any experience you gain and challenges you complete in the levels, which is a bummer to say the least considering the servers were a little bit spotty during launch week. Usually I could get back in right away, and it would save my progress offline anyway for when I reconnected so I wouldn't lose that experience, so clearly that's possible, and take that as you wish. I'm hoping IO Interactive will bend on this eventually, but buyer beware for now. Odds are, if you've already played Hitman 1 or 2, you're sold on 3 anyway and my video isn't gonna sway you, but if you're maybe looking at Hitman 3 because you want a new PS5 or Series X game, or you want to try that PSVR mode out, or whatever your reason may be, I implore you to try at least one of these games out, even if it's not 3. The intro level of Hitman 2 is available for free on console, with all of your progression transferring over if you decide to buy, and at least one of the first two games has a free game trial on Steam. In other words, you don't have to buy in to find out if you like Hitman's style. And while I may disagree with the online-only structure of Hitman 3, I still have to commend IO Interactive for making these games cross-compatible all the way through, for free if you've owned the other games. This is despite Hitman 1 being released episodically and published by Square Enix, despite Hitman 2 being published by Warner Bros. After IO Interactive bought the franchise out from Square, and despite Hitman 3 being available on 2 additional consoles and the Epic Game Store on an updated engine and self-published by IO Interactive itself. The sheer scope of the Hitman trilogy's compatibility is simply unheard of in any game ever before. The process to transfer was way easier than I expected it would be, and it was made by a studio so clearly passionate for this franchise that they took several consecutive risks with what was an unprofitable series just a few years ago in order to make all of this happen. And on top of all of that, despite Hitman 3 including all of 1 and 2 in the base file and adding a whole other game on top of that, Hitman 3 takes up a smaller amount of disk space than either of the first two games do individually. This studio just made magic happen, and it's the sort of lightning in a bottle that we will never see again. Massive respect where it's due, because the team just didn't need to do this, and nobody would have expected them to. Just keep in mind that if you're gonna transfer your save data from Hitman 2 to 3, you have to do so before you play any of 3, or else your 3 save will reset during the transfer. So if you've already got Hitman 1 or 2 in your library, without a doubt you should buy Hitman 3 to complete the saga and have access to hundreds of hours of content all in one compact place. If you're thinking of picking this game up as your first game, definitely try out one of the first two first and try to grab those on sale if you like what you play. Or you can buy Hitman 3 now, play it, and then just buy the Access Pass DLC to unlock Hitman 1 and or 2 and just keep the content coming. Just keep in mind that while Hitman 3 may have the largest levels by far in this series, it also might feel a tad light on content compared to, say, the complete editions of Hitman 1 and 2, and if you're worried about that, these games go on sale incredibly often. I think that full price is more than fair here, considering that I was gonna buy the game anyway, but when it eventually and inevitably drops to $20 to $30, it's no doubt a must-buy. Thank you very much for watching, and hopefully I gave you a good recommendation. If you're new here and you enjoyed what you saw, please subscribe so I can buy a house one day, and as always, until the next video, stay golden.